Hello guys, welcome to a new video where I will explain the Log4Shell vulnerability. How it works, how it can damage and how to prevent it. If you're ready, I will just ask you to subscribe to my channel and let's go. I think everybody heard about the Log4Shell vulnerability. It was one of the most famous vulnerability in the latest years, almost in the Java world. Nevertheless, it only impacts some libraries and some configurations. Let's see it. Here is a small application, a Spring Boot application, where I've excluded the default logging library to use the Log4j. Yes, because the vulnerability only impacts this library and only some versions. I will list them later. With this application, I only need a public endpoint. In my endpoint, I will read a header and log it. Nothing more. I know this doesn't reflect the behavior of a real application, but I will come into the details later. Let's run the application. In this header, I sent a JNDI command, a Java naming and directory interface command. And this command requests the LDAP server. And let's see how my Spring Boot application reacts. I can see that it tries to connect to the server, as indicated in the header. Even if my header is printed, if my log is printed, it handled the JNDI command before. Here is my log at the end. But how does the JNDI work? The JNDI is basically an API that provides access to remote code. My Java application using the JNDI API can access through a variety of protocols some remote code to be executed locally. In this case, I can use an LDAP connection, but I could have used RMI, Corba, or others. The logger log4j reads first the content of the header. It will detect the dollar sign and the curly brackets, which means that something interesting is inside that should be interpreted. In most cases, the interpretation is safe, which prevents any kind of malicious code to be injected. But this time, log4j left this gap unattended. So, log4j will see that it's a JNDI command and will run it. Inside, I can see that's an LDAP request, so Log4j will request this URL, nothing more. This is benign, but let's see what can be done with this request. In a malicious attack, the LDAP server is under the control of the attacker, which means that the attacker is making my application to request its LDAP server. It's an LDAP server that can respond in multiple ways. It can use some Java codebase JNDI response. This means that the response contains the location and necessary information to run a Java application that is located remotely. And of course, this remote application won't make anything good. Another way the LDAP server could respond is by running a basic base 64 command. This means that the request itself is a command encoded in base 64. The request will be done against the LDAP server, but the command will be decoded and run directly on my server. This command could be to download a malicious file and run it. That was two of the most used attacks. So, how can I prevent my application and my server against those attacks? For the codebase attack, this only happens when this property is set to true. This is set to true by default only in the Java versions lower than those versions of Java 6, 7, 8, and 11. Greater versions have this value set to false by default. Unless I set it manually to true, it shouldn't impact me. On the other side, for the basic base64 command, it can be harder to protect. One way, of course, is to upgrade the log4j library to a version higher than 2.14.1, which doesn't present the vulnerability. But this option sometimes isn't acceptable, as an application upgrade is difficult or the application is no more maintained. An alternative is putting in front of my Spring Boot application a web server that filters the LDAP requests. This way, I prevent any incoming requests against an untrusted LDAP server. In the example I've shown, I've used a custom header, which seems improbable that the attacker knows the name of my custom header and that I'm logging the content of my header. But there are some other headers that are printed by default. Let's say you use a Tomcat with a relatively verbose options for logging. Some headers will be printed by default as the host, the location, or the user agent. So even if my Spring Boot application is safe, my Tomcat server may be the problem. As I said, the best option is to upgrade the Log4j library to a version higher than 2.14.1. If the application uses another logging library as logback, there is no problem. That's all for this video. If you like it, please click on the thumbs up and see you in another video. Bye!